I wanted to do some iPhone life hacks for you because the new iPhone, I think, is being announced this week, and I just thought it'd be kind of an exciting thing to do. I'm gonna just show you like a few tips and tricks that you might not know how to do on your iPhone already. So yeah, I hope this is helpful to you guys. I know you guys are probably all better with your iPhones than I am because I'm like a grandma, but that's okay. Also, if you haven't seen it, I recently announced my last giveaway winner in this video. And I wanted to do another giveaway for you guys because you're amazing and I just want to give you guys more opportunities to win cool stuff. So, I'm going to be giving away an iPad Pro. This is the rose gold one. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber to this channel and follow me on Instagram, which will be up here and linked down below. And then just leave a comment and leave your Instagram username so I can check and make sure that you're a follower. And that's all you have to do. Also, this is a collab video with Breelyn, Lisa, and Karina. They are all doing really, really cool iPhone-related videos, so I will put them up here so you can check them out. So yeah, I'm going to stop rambling. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and let's get to it. So this first one is kind of old, but really cool. You can check your signal strength by dialing 3001 pound 12345 pound star. And right next to your cell phone carrier's name, it will give you a numeric value for how strong your signal is. So I'm not sure how to pronounce what this stuff is called, but you can find it at Target and it's like a moldable adhesive and it's just used for fixing random things, but it actually works really well as a phone case. So what you want to do is just pick out a few colors and then rub them between your hands to just kind of like mold them to the shape you want. I wrap them around the corners of my iPhone, that way when I put all of them together, the screen can't touch the whatever surface I put it on, neither can the back. And then when you drop it, it actually protects your phone. I was so nervous to actually drop this, but it worked really well. I did it about 4 times and it seemed to work pretty well. Oh, I know a lot of people like to listen to music before they go to sleep, but the problem is it ends up staying on all night and sometimes you can't really sleep as well. So what you can do is go to your timer and set it for like maybe an hour or two and then click when timer ends and then scroll down to the bottom and there's an option that says stop playing music and you can automatically set your music to turn off. So I have like a lot of embarrassing memes and selfies and things like that saved to my phone, and it always kind of stresses me out when someone's like, hey, can I get through your camera roll? And I'm like, excuse me? So what you can do is select a photo. There's an option to hide it. And this way, if someone asks for your phone and they're in the like memories or whatever it's called, where it's like photos, moments, they actually cannot see that photo when they're looking through it. So there are so many times when I need to charge my phone and there's no good place to actually set my phone down. So what you can do is use an old container to make a phone holder. Now I used an old baby powder container just because it's really easy to clean out. You could also use like a shampoo bottle. It's just going to have a lot more sticky residue, so just keep that in mind. So basically I took the lid off and then trimmed out a little piece in the front, and then taking the brick to my iPhone charger, I just traced that out with a Sharpie, and then very, very carefully I used a knife to cut it out. Just please be careful because last time I used a knife in a project, I totally sliced my hand and it was really scary. So maybe get an adult to help you, but then make sure it fits properly. I used some stickers to decorate mine just so it looked a little bit cuter, and then you can plug in your charger and then you have a place to store your phone. So if you don't like carrying around a computer, this is kind of like an easier option for you. You could just carry around a Bluetooth keyboard. Then you can actually link it to your iPhone and type notes that way, and that way it minimizes what you have to carry around. I have a beta version of iOS 10 on my phone, so I haven't used it a ton, but one of the tips I have for you when you do download it is that you can actually pause downloads, which is really cool. If you accidentally start to download something maybe while you're not on Wi-Fi, you can pause it by pressing on it. Now, this one is probably so obvious to everyone else, but I had no idea you could do this. If you go into notes and then look at the bottom, there's a little circle with a check in it. You can press that and then it creates like a bulleted list that you can actually go through and check off. Me and most of my friends actually like paste little check marks next to our list, but it actually will do it for you, which I thought was really cool.
So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about anything, you can leave them down below, and I'll see you later. Bye!